been a long weekend. The football ended only last night. It's the Tony and Tim show. We're back, and I'm Tony.
And my name is Tim.
Long weekend it was of football, of course, ending last night when Arsenal travelled to West Ham, very, very near to them, just across town to the London Stadium, and they beat West Ham away from home 3-1 in their first win in 10 games. Does it represent a turn for Arsenal?
I think it does represent a turn for Arsenal. We say that maybe when a new coach comes in, they get decent results. It wasn't for the first two games for Ljungberg. But yesterday's win, Tony, in the second half, we saw the Arsenal that can match up these bogey boys. West Ham is a bogey boy. But Arsenal was able to get that result. And to me, I thought it was Ozil, the link Ozil had between the midfielders and the strikers was key yesterday, and all the front guys ahead of Ozil got the goals. That's Martinelli, Aubameyang and Pepe. So I think if Arsenal can play that squad week in, week out, maybe they can get decent results.
Big win for Arsenal, but of course the biggest win of the weekend in our big weekend game of the weekend came in Manchester when Manchester United took on Manchester City at the Etihad. It's a result that we might not have seen coming. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer traveled there and beat Pep 2-1.
Beat Pep 2-1. You're saying it's a result we didn't expect, but having watched the game, I thought that was then a shallow result for Man United. They should have
had more.
Should have had more. Four, five goals in this one. It showed you that the two teams who played differently. Man City thought they were going to boss possession and then hit United. And then United decided to suck in the possession and counter-attack. And it was successful for them. They missed the first two, three chances, but later got in the goals from Rashford, a penalty there that I thought was rightly so given by VAR. Then later, Martial getting the goal. I thought United were brilliant, Tony, in the first half. They deserved more, and it made me question the abilities of Man City. It looks like every week we get to know that Man City is dipping off form, and the gap between them and Liverpool is evident of that.
Very, very interesting. Of course, Manchester City came here on the back of a win in the midweek, and Manchester United as well came on the back of a very impressive win also against Tottenham Hotspur. So it was two teams that had come into this game with a bit of confidence, but certainly the win against Spurs looked to have energized the Manchester United side more coming here. We talked about Pep's deficiencies at the back, in midfield, and going forward without Sergio Aguero, we knew that they would struggle.
Yeah.
But the person that struggled the most in this game was Raheem Sterling.
Yeah.
He struggled to impact the game. Wan-Bissaka was a terrific performer in this one.
Yeah, Wan-Bissaka we had a man of the match performance against Sterling. I thought it nullified all the threat from Sterling. But you also have to look at the previous games. Sterling has played about 15 games against Man United, and he hasn't scored against United. So maybe that played a part. But Wan-Bissaka was very brilliant there. Even the likes of Jesus Tony did not get the ball into their feet. It took Man City over 30 minutes to have a touch in the United box. I think that's too much.
That's shambolic
for them.
Very, very interesting. We know what Pep can do. Yeah. We know his side has almost a very good second 11 side that he can field.
Yeah.
The deficiencies for him have come in the defense.
Yeah.
We saw Mendy was missing.
Yeah.
Zinchenko, of course, was also missing in this one.
Yeah.
And they had to use
Angelino.
The young man, Angelino,
who
struggled a lot. I feel like he was targeted a lot in the early stages by James. Most of the counterattacks were coming down the left flank or the right flank for Manchester United, for that matter. So maybe it was a matter of Ole Gunnar Solskjaer getting his tactics right in this particular one. Manchester United had a very solid performance going forward. To an extent, you imagine what Pogba will have to do to get back into this Manchester side after these two performances.
Yeah, Tony. And I think for Man United, they're willing for a world-class midfielder like Pogba to come in, and I think they'll even move a step higher if Pogba came back to the team. But I don't want us to leave out the performance of Fred, Tony, and McTominay. They seem to have made up a partnership they're clicking, Tony, and Fred is starting to prove that he's a 52 million player, and if he plays like that constantly, I believe he'll be one of the first names to that starting sheet alongside McTominay. That, Tony, for me, Man U fans would want to see that. And then Pogba is the other midfielder who is released. So if that happens, let's hope Pogba comes back. We shall see how United can progress. And I hope they're able to break into the top four.
It was certainly interesting to see Manchester United now finding themselves as high as fifth in the log there, trying to get themselves back and marching towards the top four. This was a game that we saw VAR happening at both ends of the pitch.
Yeah.
One penalty given for Manchester United and a couple of claims coming from Manchester City.
Yeah.
One penalty against Fred that was ruled out.
Yeah.
The ball hit his hand while he was falling to the floor.
Yeah.
Penalty or no penalty?
No penalty, Tony, because I think when Fred approached the ball, he takes his hands at the back. And I've tried to ask around, Tony, can anyone fall when his hands are at the back? I don't think if that's possible. You got to have support when you're going down. So it's unlucky for Man City because, again, you expect it's deflected from a player running in. So maybe you think it's a penalty, but I think that it's done to the referee or the VAR official.
Very, very interesting. Of course, Manchester City now finding themselves 14 points off the pace, 6 points behind second place Leicester City, who had a very, very convincing win on the weekend. This will certainly be a very, very interesting festive period that we are entering. Of course, we know how busy the schedule is over in England. When the time comes like now, it will be interesting to see how Liverpool, Leicester try to keep that momentum going and how Pep reacts to all that. Of course, we know that up next for him is Arsenal.
Yeah.
That's certainly a must win for him.
It's a must win for him, but Tony, just like we've said, Arsenal started clicking. So Arsenal will not worry. They've seen Man United. That's almost the same level as Arsenal, picking out points from the Etihad. So for me, if I'm the Arsenal manager, I also go ahead and target the weak spots of Man City. And I'll not be surprised if Arsenal can get a result against Man City.
Big ones, of course. Football never stops. We'll be back after the break with more results. Stay tuned.